Up in lights, he just wants to be heard, whether it's the beat or the mic. He feels so unlike everybody else, alone in spite of the fact that some people still think that they know him. But fuck him, he knows the code. It's not about the salary, it's all about reality and making some noise, making a story, making sure his click stays up. That means when he puts it down, Tok's picking it up. Let's go.
Who the hell is he anyway? He never really talks much, never concerned with status, but still even in starstruck. Humble through opportunities given despite the fact that many misjudge him cause he makes a living from writing raps. Put it together himself, got a picture connects. Never asking for someone's help, but to get some respect. He's only focused on what he wrote, his will is beyond reach. And now it all unfolds, the skill of an artist.
This is 20% skill, 80% fear. Be 100% clear, cause Ryu was ill. Who would've thought he'd be the one that set the West in flames? And I heard him wreck it with the crystal method, name of the game. Came back, dropped Megadeth, took him to church. I like Bleach, man, Ryu had the stupidest verses. Dude, it's the truth, now everybody giving him guest spots. His stock's through the roof, I heard he fuck him with S-Dot.
This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason to remember the name.
They call him Ryu, he's sick and he's spitting fire and Mike. Got him out the dryer, he's hot. Found him in Fort Minor with Tok, but a fucking nihilist porcupine. He's a prick, he's a cop. The type women wanna be within, rappers hope he gets shot. 8 years in the making, patiently waiting to blow. Now the record with Shinoda's taking over the globe. He's got a partner in crime, his shit is equally dope. You won't believe the kind of shit that comes out of this kid's throat. Tok,
he's not your everyday on the block. He knows how to work with what he's got, making his way to the top. He often gets a comment on his name. People keep asking him, was it giving that birth or does it stand for an acronym? No, he's living proof. Let him rock in the booth. He'll get you buzzing quicker than a shot of vodka with juice. Him and his crew are known around as one of the best. Dedicated to what they do and give 100%.
Forget Mike. Nobody really knows how or why he works so hard. It seems like he's never got time because he writes every note and he writes every line. And I've seen him at work when that light goes on in his mind. It's like a design that's written in his head every time before he even touches a key or speaks in a rhyme. And those motherfuckers he runs with, the kids that he signed, ridiculous without even trying. How do they do it?
This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason to remember the name. This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason to remember the name.
Yeah. Fort Minor, M. Shinoda, Styles of Beyond, Ryu, Tok Beer, Machine Shop.
Through the maze of rights and wrongs, but like you used to say, nothing feels like it's really worth it. Forget perfect, I'm trying not to be worthless. Since I last saw you, I've been looking for a purpose. Well, I met this kid who thought like I did. He had a weird way of looking at it. This is what he said: slip out the back before they know you were there, and at the worst you'll see nobody cares. Cause you don't wanna be around when it all goes down. Even heroes know when to be scared. Slip out the back before they know you were there, and at the worst you'll see nobody cares. Cause you don't wanna be around when it all goes down. Even heroes know when to be scared.
Now, I don't remember where I met him or remember his name, but he walked funny like he was just too big for his frame. Just over 5 foot, but he weighed 150. And what he said seemed so right, it stuck with me. Listen, it's like poker, you can play your best, but you gotta know when to fold your cards and take a rest. And know when to hold your cards, hold your breath, and hope that nobody else is stacking the deck, because Cause I don't need to tell you that life isn't fair. It doesn't care, it arbitrarily cuts off your air. And like you, I want someone to say it's okay. In the truest part of our hearts, everybody's afraid. We're just underappreciated and overwhelmed, fighting so